So starting on your hands and your knees, press the tops of your toes down. Inhale, arch your spine, cow pose. Exhale, round your spine, cat pose. Upper shoulder soft. Draw your shoulders back, pull your heart through cow pose. Exhale, round your spine, shoulder blades move apart. But the neck should feel free. You don't want to feel like you're squeezing your shoulders up. Inhale, heart through cow pose. Good, that's it, Sid. Exhale, round the spine, cat. Now, you want a little more work here. Squeeze your ankles in and lift onto the tops of your feet. That'll work. The front of your ankles and the front of your shin, tibialis anterior, which could lead you to a little more ankle mobility. So keep the knees down if you want less work. Lift the knees up if you want more core work and a little more work for the ankles. It's strong. It's not easy. And you know it's really strong if you lift your knees up and then straighten your legs onto your toes into a down dog. Really strong work for the ankles, but that's another option. Cat pose or lifting to the tops of the feet or even taking it to a funky down dog. Two more. Woo! Your foot might get crampy. Normal. Strong work, but good for you. Said like a mom. And then hold here. So option A, child's pose. Option B, tuck toes, down dog. If you're in down dog, push your arms forward. So push your mat away from you. Lift your hips high. You want to untuck the butt. So some of us tuck the butt under in down dog. This is a pose that you want to untuck the butt. And bend one knee. Now, if I bend one knee, I might be able to untuck the butt more, which is going to give me more hamstrings. And then on the straight leg, so my left heel is pretty much down, I can pull my left toes up, and that engages the arches of my foot on that side, and I might get a deeper calf stretch. Hold for another breath, and then change. Right heel comes down, left heel lifts. Push your arms, untuck the butt, especially on the right side. Right? Maybe lift your right toes up. Deep breath in. Full breath out. So if you're in child's pose, join us in down dog. Both heels down. Down dog is a strengthening prep pose for handstand. It's an inversion. I don't love this pose for hamstrings because a lot of us don't have the ankle flexibility to really get into the hamstrings here. So this to me is more about arms and inversion. And if I want to make it even more about arms and core strength, then I pull to plank pose and I hold for 5 breaths. So down dog is easier for most of us. Plank is a little harder. Awesome. Awesome, Laura. Awesome, Penny. Awesome, Barbette. Yes, saw it. Look, Penny, Paula, and Barbette, you both felt it at the same time. Good lift of the head. Awesome. Great, Jackie. Come back to down dog. Now walk your hands back to your feet. This, to me, is a better pose to open the hamstrings. So let yourself relax and forward fold. You might lift your 10 toes up again. And then I love to pull my big toes in and my pinky toes out. That engages the feet. Great work for the feet. Let your neck be heavy. Shake it out. Keep your weight forward. All right, let's add some spinal work. Inhale, half lift, Ardha Uttanasana. This is all about lengthening the spine, strengthening the spine, and working the legs. Draw your belly in, cactus your arms. Inhale, reach your arms forward, but go wide, go wide, go wide. Exhale, pull back. Lat work. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, pull back. Inhale, reach forward. Strengthen flexibility. 3 more times. Reach. 3, 2, and one. Release everything down. Turn your heels in and your toes out. You can widen your feet. Rock side to side. Rock side to side. And then go ahead and sit down into a malasana squat. Great. Bring your hands to your heart. Push your legs wide and lift your chest up. Now try to stick your butt out a little bit. Try to stick your butt out a little bit. Deep breath in, full breath out. Lift your heart even higher. Good. Good. Press your thighs open. Try to feel your outer feet. Now do the opposite. Round everything in, but keep your legs wide. Round everything forward. Tuck your chin towards your chest. Deep flexion for your lower back. The buttock has to also be opening here to maintain this position. Two more cycles of breath. Can you get any heavier in any of this? Can you get any heavier? Meaning do less work. Maybe even turn your palms up for your final breath. Shoulders relaxed. Begin to straighten your legs. Turn your feet forward. Walk all the way out. Plank pose. Lower your knees. Untuck your toes. Keep your head lifted. Just a little more, Laura. Good, Penny. Now, just bring your shoulder blades together. Keep your arms straight. Now, pull your shoulder blades apart. Keep your arms straight. Shoulder blades together. Shoulder blades apart. Shoulder blades together. I'm working my rhomboids deeper than traps. Shoulder blades apart. I'm working serratus anterior. These two muscles work together to create shoulder stability. Two more. Shoulder blades together. Shoulder blades apart. Arms are basically straight, not a push-up, not a full push-up. And then bend your elbows, come all the way down. Great. Bring your elbows in front of you, Sphinx pose. Press your hands down, roll your shoulders back. From the middle of your back, reach forward first. Then pull the shoulders back, elbows squeeze in. Heart is lifted, gaze is forward. You should be able to easily turn your head side to side. Option A is Sphinx pose. Option B, tuck toes, lift hips, forearm plank. Breathing in, breathing out, breathing in, breathing out, hold steady. Four, three, two, hips down if they're lifted. Back to Sphinx pose, untuck. Great, Paula. Shoulders back. So you can make this pose pretty strong. Toenails press down. Lengthen your inner knees towards your feet. Pubic bone presses down. That'll take some of it out of the low back. Mid-spine reaches forward. Front shoulders pull back. Neck is free. Two more breaths. Lower down. Bring your hands back, press through a half push-up, tuck your toes, exhale, lift your hips, downward facing dog. Deep breath in, full breath out. Lift up high to the balls of your feet, bend your knees, empty your breath, come all the way to the top of the mat. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, forward fold, press down, rise up, reach all the way up. Samasthitihi, hands to heart. Okay, I'm just turning towards you so you can see. Step your left foot over to the right. Turn your hips forward. Interlace your fingers. No, I lied. Bring your left wrist in front and your right hand underneath. So palms facing out. Lift everything up behind your head and then bow to your right. So this crossing of your wrist might give you a little more wrist opening with side bend and side hip work. Look to the right, so gaze down. That's a little easier on the neck. Turn your chest more to the right. Breath in and breath out. One more. Rise all the way up. Step your left foot forward. Reach your arms up and around. Up and around. Let your knees bend a little bit. Up and around. Up and around. One more time. Great. Great, great, great. Step your right foot over to the left. So kind of like a little bit of a curtsy. Bring your arms out in front of you. Turn your palms away. Bring your right wrist on top of your left. Turn your palms away from each other. Lift up. Behind you. And then bow over to your left. Strongly press the ball of your right foot down. Turn your chest more to the left. Look down. Turn your chest more to the left. Shoulders, wrists, balance, hip, waistline. Rise all the way up, release. Just a little step out. So I'm still facing forward, but my knees are slightly bent. And then twist, twist, twist. Keep your knees a little bent so there's play through the hip and the knee. Good, little qigong, opening up. Now you can make your arms come up higher so you're more at heart level, or you can keep your arms lower so you're more at lower back. And you might even make a loose fist and kind of pat your back or your heart or your upper back. That's it, get the energy moving. Easy twist for the spine. That's it. Four more. Three, two, one. Fantastic. Inhale, arms reach to the sky. Palms join, exhale, forward fold. Let your head hang heavy. Take an extra breath in here. Don't lift, just take an extra breath in and an extra breath out. Now we'll add half lift. Inhale, half lift, long spine, shoulders back. Exhale, release, giant step back with your right foot, knee comes down. Squeeze your foot and back knee in, so feel your inner thighs get together, then reach your arms up. Inhale. Exhale, cactus your arms and lunge into your front leg. Stick your butt out. Awesome, Noreen. Stick your butt out. Try to make it more back bendy in the lower back. More back bendy in the lower back. Yes, some of us need more of that. Now come back up. Take it out. Inhale. Exhale, bring your hands down, downward facing dog. Give yourself an extra breath in down dog. Decide if you want to hold dog as your strength position, if you want to hold plank as your strength position, or you want to take chaturanga, cobra, and up dog. Now, if your shoulders are tender or funky, I think down dog or plank is a great way to build strength, skip the flow, and just hold those poses, and then you're not putting yourself up against it so much. Inhale, right leg lifts to the sky. In down dog. Exhale, knee to chest three times. You can stay in dog and it'll be shorter, or you come pull forward to plank, and then you'll step your right foot forward, lower your left knee down. Mm-hmm. Scissors, beautiful, Sid. Beautiful. Nice, David. Draw your right foot to your left knee, so find that intentionality in the thighs, then reach your arms up, inhale. Exhale, cactus your arms, sink a little deeper, and then get more back bendy. A lot of times you'll have teachers tell you not to ever get back bendy here. Today, get a little back bendy so we open up that lower back in a way that could be good for you if your tendency is to be more flexy there and less back bendy. Reach up, pull out, inhale, and exhale, hands to the floor, step forward. Next breath in, half lift. Next breath out, exhale, fold. Shake your head out if you need to. Press your feet down, stand all the way up, rise up. And then pull your hands to your heart, exhale. Inhale, arms right away, Urdhva Hasta Tadasana. Exhale, hands through heart center, forward fold. Take two breaths in forward fold, so not rushing the sun salutation. Deep breath in. Full breath out. Inhale, half lift, long spine. Exhale, hands to the earth, big step back with your left foot, knee comes down. Right away, sweep up, inhale. Right away, exhale, back to the earth, downward facing dog. Hold to build strength, hold plank to build strength, or flow. Knees up or down. We meet in downward facing dog. Deep breath in, full breath out. Deep breath in. Awesome, Paula. Great. From down dog, lift your left leg up. Exhale three times. Knee to chest. Inhale, lift. So back to core, shoulders. One more. And then step through. You're also getting hip extension here, right? Lower your right knee right away. Inhale, rise up. Right away. Exhale, come back down. Step your right foot forward. Half lift. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Press into your feet. Rise all the way up. Samasthiti, hands to heart. Inhale, circle up. Exhale, sweep your arms back. Sit into a low chair. Go low with your butt. Now reach your arms and heart up. Inhale, chair pose. Breath in. Breath out. Breath in. Forward fold, two breaths. Emphasize this forward fold here. Let the neck go. Add your half lift, inhale. Exhale, giant step back with your right foot. Roll open, Virabhadrasana 2, Warrior 2. Turn your right foot in a little bit. Make your right leg long. How do I make my right leg long? I can think of lifting my right arch up to my hip. I can think of reaching my upper knee on the inside down to my outer foot. Both of those ideas will probably help you straighten up. Reach here, inhale, and exhale. Roll your right shoulder more open. So Warrior 2 works a little more side hip. Now pivot forward, shift onto the ball of your right foot, come through crescent pose, reach both arms up to the sky, and then circle your hands down. Exhale, downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Hold dog or plank to build strength or flow. We meet in down dog. Right leg lifts. Bend your right knee. Open up your right hip. Circle your right knee. So if I keep it just here in dog circling, it's easier. If I circle forward and up and around into plank, it's more work. Do one more circle either way. And then step your right foot forward. Spin your left foot flat. Rise up, Warrior 1. Same process. Upper inner knee to outer foot or inner arch to the front hip. All right, bring your left arm forward. Bring your right arm under. Bring your palms together, eagle wrap. Drop your forehead down. Back of the neck is stretching. Forearms opening, wrists opening. Shoulders in the back are opening, or upper spine. Legs are strong. Keep the arms, lift your gaze. Reach your arms up, inhale. Exhale, hands to the earth. Standing forward fold, take two breaths, emphasizing a little bit more opening here. Now half lift, inhale, exhale, release, press into your feet, stand all the way up, arms reach to the sky, samasthiti, hands to heart. Inhale, arms reach to the sky. Exhale, extend your arms back, shoulder opening, sit low chair, then keep the heart lifted, stay low, arms up, three breaths. Release to the earth, exhale. Inhale, half lift, long spine. Exhale, hands to the earth, giant step back with your left foot. Rise up, warrior two. Now, if you notice that your right knee is collapsing in, that's a key that you need to turn your left hip more forward. It might feel like you're in between warrior one and warrior two. That's not a bad thing. Chest turns open. This left shoulder wants to kind of pull forward. Really reach it back. Get longer through your right side body. Lengthen here. Deep breath in. Full breath out. Gaze forward, either at your chest level or over your right hand. Make your back leg longer, either by reaching your inner arch up or reaching your upper inner knee to your outer foot. Take a deep breath in, reach through the left arm more clearly, and then come onto the ball of your left foot, passing through crescent pose. Inhale, strong reach to the ball of the foot. Great work for the calf. Exhale, hands to the earth, downward facing dog, or plank pose, or flow. Breath in, breath out. Inhale from dog, lift your left leg up, bend your knee, open your hip and circle, staying in dog, or harder work, circling towards plank. 3, 2, 1. We step the left foot forward. We spin our right foot flat. This is warrior one, rise up. Same process with the back leg, strong and steady. Then bring your right arm across. There's a little twist in the spine. Left elbow hooks, palm to palm, eagle arms, back to shoulder opening. Strong and steady legs. Front hip and the right side is opening. Let your neck fall in, releasing the back of the neck. 5 breaths. Reach both arms to the sky. Inhale. Circle your hands to the earth. Exhale. Step forward. Let your head hang heavy. 2 full breaths in Uttanasana. So emphasizing the forward fold. You got it. Good. From here, half lift. Inhale. And then whatever foot makes sense, step back, turn into Prasarita Padottanasana, wide-legged forward fold standing for an inversion. Now, if you want to go to the wall and take a handstand or a headstand, feel free to do that here. I'm going to give you a whole bunch of options. Option A, in wide-legged forward fold, walk your hands out so your upper body's in a down dog. This is a great way to practice down dog if you find that pose hard, and especially if you have a hard time getting your heels down. Now you get your heels down probably. Or walk your hands backwards. Now I'm taking a deeper flexion, a deeper fold. This might be nice on the lower back or not nice on the lower back, depending. Classically, you hold your big toes. That's the finished product if you want holding of the big toes to pull yourself through. And some of you might want to stand up with the legs wide, interlace your hand the way that doesn't feel comfortable. So if you always go right, go left, you always go left, go right, roll your shoulders back and take a shoulder opener in this inversion. Whatever choice you're making, 8 breaths. If your arms are clasped, go ahead and release them now down to the earth. Half lift, inhale. Exhale, turn whatever direction makes sense and sit down on your tush. All right, lean back, create space. Turn your hands any direction that feels comfortable for you. Roll your shoulders back. Bring your right knee to your chest and then cross your right ankle above your left knee. Roll your shoulders back and reach your chest as though your chest was going to come over your shin bone. So seated figure four, seated pigeon pose. Okay, if it feels pretty easy, you can make it more intensive or deeper by shifting your left foot in and then also walking your chest closer to your shin. You may not need to. The big question is, am I getting into my outer hip? If I feel my outer right hip, then I'm probably perfect. Some of you can drop your legs to the left and roll your shoulder back and you'll feel a bigger stretch. Some of you can come up and bring your left elbow around your knee and get a bigger stretch. So this is more of a twist and a hip opener. But some of you will feel like you get more bang for your buck in the first one. So just go where it feels right in your body. I'm just giving you options for you to figure out, play around with what feels good for you today. If you're in the twist, come back up, meet us. And then we're all going to walk backwards. Roll your shoulders open. Extend your spine, pull your elbows in, hold here or lift your butt up for reverse tabletop. This is a modified variation. The full variation is with the legs straight out, kind of like what we practiced on the blocks earlier. Tush comes down. Left ankle crosses pretty high up on the leg, so be careful about pulling your foot down. Roll your shoulders back, sit up nice and tall. If I'm being honest, I'm already feeling it. I can walk my body all the way in. I have that flexibility, but I don't even need to feel my hip. Now, 20 years ago, I didn't feel my hips ever. So this is all new territory. Walk it in if you need a little more intensity. And again, this side might be different. When you turn it to a twist and bring your arm around, you might get something interesting on this side that you didn't get on the first side. And if you want more twists, then this is the one for you. And if you want more hip, probably, but some of you will feel more hip in the twist, come back here. Good. If you're in the twist, exhale your way back through center, feet down, shoulders back, back bend, roll the shoulders back and or lift the hips up or straighten both legs out for full Purvottanasana. And release. Extend your legs long. So, to be safe in Paschimottanasana, you should be able to come forward from your hips. A lot of you will do this. You'll round the spine and you'll reach forward. I don't want to say this is unsafe, but it's potentially unsafe for the discs of your lower back. So if you are prone to disc herniation, I just wouldn't do this pose unless I could do this. So I'm extending my lower back first and then I'm folding. How do I get out of that? I might have to sit up on a block or a bolster or a pillow. Usually if you get higher, then you have more ability to roll forward from the hip. But now my knees are a little bit of an issue. So I'd want to put something under my knees so that they're not kind of buckling backwards, right? If that's another problem. I could also keep my knees a little bit bent. However, this is better for my back, but I may not be getting that much hamstring because I bent my knees to accommodate what my hips can't do. That's why I always say, take the hip openers that work for your body. If you really want to focus on hamstrings, then the safer bet and the probably deeper bet is going to be to come onto your back and do one-legged reclined splits, or you can call this Supta Padangusthasana A. I'm pulling, if you're in the reclined version with me, I'm pulling my toes back, but I'm reaching my big toe more forward, my pinky toe more out and down. Now, for some of us, even here, being on the back, it's still aggressive on the right hamstring. So you can always bend your left knee, which gives you more accessibility into the hamstring. And with muscle lengthening, it's not important that you get into a pose all the way to get a benefit. What's important is that you're changing the length of the muscle at all. That's the benefit for your body. So if you're super flexible, then you're going to look like you're in the pose more fully. And if you're not, you won't. But that's not the point. The point is, am I having an effect on the part of my body that I want to? That's really, in terms of healthy aging and overall physical benefit, that is the important part. The yogic part is not being too attached, right? Trusting that your process is your process, and your process is great for you if it's leading you to more happiness, wholeness, healthiness, etc. Okay, if you're on your back changing legs, you can emphasize reaching up to the big toe and kind of out and down to the pinky. You can emphasize lengthening the upper inner knee towards the foot. You can back out of it a little bit. It might give you more range of motion to keep your right knee bent. If you're still seated, join us on the back. Good. Release both feet to the earth. If you're ready for a deeper twist, you can cross your right knee over your left knee. Move your hips to the right. And if it's too deep to cross your knees, then just keep your knees uncrossed. Drop both knees to the left. For the neck, shift your head to the right and then turn your head to the left. This is a less aggressive opening for the neck than the traditional looking away from the knees. So you still get a rotation at the neck, but it's a softer rotation. If you feel tension in your right shoulder, drop your right arm down just an inch or two. All right, turn your head to center. Uncross your legs if they're crossed. Come back to center. And then if you're crossing left knee over right, shift your hips over to the left, drop your knees to the right, head neutral, or scoot your head a little bit to the left before turning it to the right, and you'll find that you get a little more clearance that way. If you feel tension in your left shoulder, if it feels like you're holding on there, drop your left arm down a couple of inches. That's it. And then let go. Try to give over completely to the twist so that you're not managing yourself or holding on anywhere. to come out. Turn your head forward. And then exhale, unwind your legs, come back through center. If you need a neutralizing pose before Shavasana, bring your knees in or hold your feet for happy baby, wiggle around, rock around if you need to do that. Take a couple of breaths. And then when you're ready, drop into your variation of Shavasana, letting go. Bring your attention to the stillness of your body. Simply notice and observe any sensations that are arising out of your stillness. Observe the rise and fall of your lower belly as you breathe in and as you breathe out. Observe the rise and fall of your belly. As you begin to notice the sensations while observing the rise and fall of your belly, invite those sensations to spread throughout your entire body. The whole body is feeling the sensations that you're noticing by watching the belly. Notice if it feels like you're not breathing. Observe that quality. Invite your breath to line up with that energetic, non-breathing quality. so that your breath is less efforted. It might even feel deeper or richer, but no effort, maybe no sound. You might want to continue to rest and notice that, or that can lead you into some movement that leads you to sitting up. Your choice. If you are seated, bring your hands to your heart. Just give yourself a moment to decide how you want to feel after this practice is over. Whatever you're going into next, what would you love to feel like? Deep breath in, full breath out. Namaste.